Of course, ACE takes advantage of all of the development environment's advantages. For example, when you're debugging, if you're using Visual Basic 6, the F8 key will step you through the code. In .NET, it's F10 and 11. And to run, you would press F5. Those are all standard features of Visual Basic development environment. The mouse tooltips work just like they would with any other Visual Basic program. How they look will differ slightly if you're using Visual Basic 6 or .NET. And of course, you can use watches for your variables to figure out what's going on as the code as you follow through the code. There is one small difference when you're debugging with the .NET Studio environment. Unlike Visual Basic 6, which compiles an executable for each of its ACE calculations, VB.NET compiles DLLs, which are then hosted by the PyACE class library host executable file. It's a subtle difference, but what it means is that when we test a DLL in .NET, we have to open up a DOS window, compile the assembly, load the assembly, and return to Visual Studio. So that is a behavior that you will experience in .NET that you will not in the Visual Basic 6 development environment. It's a very subtle difference and probably not going to mean too much other than just a flashing DOS window temporarily. Before you register any ACE module, you will need to test it first. Testing will save your project in the module database. And with VB6, it will compile the code and generate the executable. However, it does not write values to Py. There is one little exception to this. If your code actually uses the put value function or some other function that forces a write to the Py server, it will write the values. But for the most part, if you're just outputting the tags, it does not write values to Py. There is one other small difference when you're using the different development environments. If you're using the .NET Studio, because you're simply compiling DLLs and running them against a master executable, you don't need to stop the executable to test any changes. However, if you're using Visual Basic 6, Visual Basic 6 will not let you change an executable while it's running, so you will need to take the executable out of service in order to do any additions or changes or testing to it. We do have a procedure that you can get around that, but if you absolutely can't stop the executable, and you can find that in the book, but for the most part you will have to stop the executable in the ACE manager when you're dealing with Visual Basic 6. When you're dealing with .NET, you will not be required to do that, and we give you in the ACE wizard a full test environment where you can use the current or typical values and run your calculations. This will tell you whether you have good values as a result of your calculation or you need to work more with your code.